Oh, hi. I didn't see you there. I was just grinding some coffee. I was just grinding some coffee with my coffee grinder. Do you love the smell of freshly ground coffee? Wow, that smells so good. Hey, in this lesson, I'm going to teach you how to describe a coffee grinder. Okay, this is called a coffee grinder. Now, this is a manual coffee grinder, right? I'm grinding it manually. Manual. It's not electric. I'm not plugging it in somewhere, right? It's using my hand power, right? So we can say I'm grinding it by hand. I'm grinding it by hand, not using some other form of power like wind or water or electricity or anything, right? I'm using my hand. So if something is by hand, that means you are doing it yourself. Like if you make cookies by hand, that means you are making the cookies. So this thing could be called a hand grinder or a manual grinder. To grind means to rub two hard things together for the purpose of breaking down something, right? You need to grind the beans. Okay, look at these coffee beans here. We need to somehow grind them to make them smaller, right? Unless you just want to eat a whole coffee bean. You know, I think you can buy chocolate covered coffee beans. So you might just like eating whole coffee beans. But to make coffee, the drink, you need to grind the coffee beans. Okay, so that's what grind means. Grind means to rub two hard things together, just like you can grind your teeth. Do you grind your teeth at night when you sleep? Some people grind their teeth. Their teeth rub together, right? And that's not good, you know, to grind your teeth. It's not good for your teeth. But in here, right in here, there are sort of two ceramic pieces that move to grind, to break down the coffee. Okay, so to grind something means to break it down into smaller pieces. Okay, so let's take a look at the different parts. What are the different parts here? Let's start with this. What would you call this? This piece here. Look, it's detachable. This is like a little travel coffee grinder. You can store the handle. Oh, I just gave it away. Okay, you can store it in here. So you could call this a handle, okay? Anything you hold, or you know, if you're taking a bus ride and it's really bumpy, you know, there might be some sort of a handle you can hold in the bus so that you don't fall over. Okay, so you could call this a handle, but I think the better word for this would be a crank. Crank. Okay, a crank is something that sort of has a circular motion. Okay, so we are cranking. So the verb is, the action is crank. Okay, so I'm cranking this, but this piece is a noun, right? And it's a crank. It's called a crank. Okay, if you want to be more specific, you know, you could call this part of the handle or crank the knob. Okay, so this is the knob and this is the arm of the handle or the arm of the crank. Now the crank turns the shaft. Okay, so this part of the machine is the shaft. So the crank turns the shaft, and the shaft is connected to one of the ceramic pieces. Okay, the other ceramic piece is sort of around the outside, and then the shaft turns the whatever, one of the ceramic pieces, and that's how it grinds the coffee. Okay, so this is the shaft. This is the crank. Now, what about this rubber piece? This black piece is a rubber ring. You could just call it a rubber ring. I don't know what it's for. I think it's just to give you more grip when you hold it, you know, so it doesn't slip out of your hands. And also, it's for storing the crank or the handle. Okay, so after the coffee gets ground, okay, then it goes into this thing. This thing just comes off here. Look at that. Look at all that fresh coffee. Okay, these are called coffee grounds. coffee grounds. Not coffee grinds, coffee grounds, I think. Let me think about that. Are they coffee grinds or coffee grounds? Now I'm confused. I think they're coffee grounds. Okay, you grind the coffee beans and that produces coffee grounds. Okay, so these are called grounds. And they just fall into, right, you can see here, those are the ceramic pieces. After the coffee is ground, they get stored in this thing. Okay, now what is this? What would you call this? Well, you could call this a container, right? A container is anything that sort of holds something. But because this is part of the machine, I think there's a better word. The first word I thought of when I looked at this is the word hopper. The word hopper. Okay, have you ever heard that word before? A hopper is like a container for holding raw material. Raw material like grain or rock or something, usually after it has been processed in some way. Okay, so imagine if this were like a giant machine and we were breaking rocks down into gravel. Okay, broken rocks, you know, they use broken rocks to make gravel roads, right? I don't know what kind of a machine they use to break down the rocks, but let's say it's a machine like this and they break down the rocks. And they store them in part of the machine, then you could call that the hopper. Or for example, a combine. Do you know what a combine is? A combine is a piece of farm machinery, a big thing like a tractor that you drive along your field, and it picks up the wheat, okay, and it somehow separates the wheat kernels from the chaff. Okay, so the chaff gets blown out the back of the combine, and the kernels of wheat get stored in a big container at the top of the combine, and that's called the hopper, the combine's hopper. Okay, so like I said, the word hopper is a word you can use for talking about a container used for storing some kind of raw goods. That especially after it has been processed. So this for this, right, we've just ground the coffee beans and now we're storing them here. And this is part of this, right? If this weren't part of this, and this was just a different piece, like a jar, if this was like a metal jar, you can see there's some glass there. If this is like some sort of a container just to put on your shelf, then I would call it a container. If it was glass, then I would call it a little jar, or you could use the word container as well. But because it's part of this system, it's part of this machine, I would call this the grinder's hopper, the hopper. So that might be a new word that you guys didn't know. Okay, what else? I think that's it. Oh, did I put it together upside down? I put it together upside down. Okay, so this is there. This, I don't know what this would, you could just call this the lid. Or the top of the coffee grinder. Okay, there we go. Now I'll just keep grinding my coffee. Now you know a few more advanced English words. You know, I hope I can make more lessons like this in the future because I think, you know, as an English learner, how would you ever learn words like hopper or crank unless someone teaches you? So I hope I can teach you more things like this, how to describe things, because, you know, in most English books or in most situations in English, you never really hear the word hopper or crank. I mean, they're normal English words, they're common English words, but they're very specific, right? You don't hear them in a normal situation. Like, you know, I don't usually use the word hopper or crank every day in everyday English, but you know, they're important words because they're part of the English language and they're very specific. So let me know down there in the comments if you want to learn more things like this, how to describe a piece of machinery or a piece of equipment or just, I don't know, something around the house. This morning I was just thinking, hey, this might be helpful for some of you guys to learn, you know, some new words. So I hope that's helpful. Go out and buy yourself a manual or hand coffee grinder and make yourself a great cup of coffee. this morning. Hope you guys are having a wonderful day wherever you are, and I'll see you over in the next episode of Mad English TV. Take care.